This edition of the Ridley Report is brought to you by
RidleyReport.com. At news releases, I am the bomb.
You can't bring that camera.
You have to leave that outside.
I'm sorry, are you telling me there's no freedom of the press in this building, sir?
I didn't say that. I said you can't bring that camera.
Okay, well, I'm a member of the media.
Well, buried amongst all the hubbub and government crackdowns lately, there is some positive news. Of course, as you may know, liberty activists have repeatedly descended on Milford District Court in Milford, New Hampshire. And the court initially reacted in sort of an overhanded way. Heavy-handed, I guess I should say. They jailed two activists for failing to take off their hats immediately, and banned cameras from the inside of the courtroom. But activists report they've also been doing some good things. Mike Barsky from mail2jail.com, mail-to-jail.com, reports the following. He says a judge there has been issuing sentences of restitution. That is presumably direct restitution to victims of crimes. That's a very popular type of move in libertarian circles. Additionally, two trials after the infamous hat arrest, authorities at Milford District Court have started allowing folks to wear hats again, both inside and outside the courtroom. And lastly, they have made no big deal out of the fact that many activists are just declining to stand when the judge enters. Now, the further they proceed down that path, the more likely it is that folks will stand for them. As Ian Freeman from Free Talk Live puts it, he says basically the judge is being tyrannical, but she's being very PR conscious about it and trying to be polite about it. Which, again, is different from what was happening at the beginning of this, when our people were actually roughly assaulted, or at least they alleged they were, and we couldn't even see it or videotape it because we weren't allowed to be in the area or have our cameras. And that's why most of the video you see here is shot outside of the courthouse. Anyway, credit where credit is due. It's good that they're, using restitution sentences in place of fines to the state in some cases, and it's good that they're letting hats back in. Although the folks who went back in with their hats did have to they had to file a motion or something like that to be able to wear their hats. These are baby steps in the right direction on the part of Milford District Court. It's Dave Ridley signing off for RidleyReport.com this March 27th, 2009.
Whoa. Is this what happens to you when you try to write or distribute a news release?
Then I beg you, end the suffering.
Deploy instead the man who got Mike Fisher's outlaw manicure front page coverage in nearly every New Hampshire media outlet. Unleash the writing force that put the Free State Project on CNN and Russell Canning on the front page of Dig.
You know where to find this force. You are staring at it.
Email it. Email me at RidleyReport.com. And let's get to work.
RidleyReport.com. At news releases, I am the bomb.